Well, in football, a blitz is an all-out attack. And sometimes in life, we face things that feel like a blitz. There are times when we feel as if life wants to take us out and leave us flat on our backs. Well, thankfully, there's hope, and a good quarterback knows that a blitz can also be an opportunity. Take a look.
Football has always been a big part of the Kemp family. Jeff and his dad, Jack, were the first of six father-son quarterbacks in the NFL. Then, in 1992, after 11 seasons and four teams, Jeff's career finally ended. In his book, Facing the Blitz, Jeff shares three things he's learned about bouncing up, not back, from life's challenges.
Well, Jeff Kemp is here with us now, and welcome to 700 Club
Thanks,
Interactive.
Thanks, Gord. Good to be with you.
I tell you, I watch a lot of football, and when
Me
I
too.
See a blitz coming at a quarterback, and I imagine what would I do in that situation, I tell you, I'd run away. I wouldn't want to stand there and try to connect a pass. I would just say, I'm done. I'm out. What kept you from doing that?
Well, you're well prepared. I mean, as a rookie, you're kind of afraid of the blitz, but as you get trained by the coaches, you realize that the blitz is not just the most dangerous moment of the game, but it's also one of the greatest opportunities, because maybe the defense has, you know, five guys attacking the quarterback, but they have fewer covering the pass. Mm-hmm. So that's where some of the biggest touchdowns come from. So the gist of facing the blitz in football is face it head on, stay in the pocket. Deal with it, but you got to adjust quickly. You got to have to adapt. You have to turn to your teammates. You have to be kind of self-sacrificing, and great things can happen from it. And the parallels to life are huge. I mean, Jesus even talked about the blitz. He said, "In this world, you're going to get blitzed."
Right.
I don't know if you have the NFL version of John 16:33. Yeah, you're going to have trouble. And Paul talked about it in Romans mm-hmm. chapter 5. He said, "We rejoice not just in salvation and peace, but we rejoice in tribulation and trials." Blitzes, if you will, because they bring about perseverance, and that brings character like Christ, and that brings hope, and hope doesn't disappoint because you feel more of God's love when you count on Him, not your circumstances, for your joy.
You spent 11 seasons in the NFL, and what was it like to put that down, to say,
it's hard.
I'm going to leave that?
I was a Christian and grew through my years in football. It was a very insecure career, so I really built more and more of my identity around Christ. But mm-hmm. I found out that when I was rejected by the NFL, that I still had too much of my identity and security in that job, in that role as a quarterback. And I remember, you know, going out to my front porch when the league rejected me, and I was so upset, and I was sitting there having this pity party. I told God I wasn't even going to pray. And wow. I'm sitting there hanging my head.
And you're praying and saying,
I was the Bible study leader on the team, you know.
Oh.
But I'm saying, no, God, I'm not going to pray. I'm just going to feel this stinking pain. And I'm sitting out there, and my wife came out, which is one of the keys to facing blitzes. You need to be transparent and honest and ask for help. You need a team.
Yeah.
And she said, oh, Jeff, I can't imagine how much this hurts. But I just want to remind you, God's always been there when we've had something tough happen. I said, I know that. I just want to finish with some dignity. And she said, you know, as I recall, Jesus left this world and didn't get any dignity. Maybe you need to let go of that desire. And Gordon, in the next couple seconds, the worst moment of my professional career, not as bad as what some of our listeners are facing, but something tough, converted to the best moment of my life because I had the epiphany of what Jesus did for me to show me His love, to forgive my sins, to give me eternal life, to give His Spirit to me, all by suffering the greatest blitz in history for me. I started to cry tears of joy for love for Christ. And I experienced that Romans 5 hope and joy and love in my tribulation. And then I heard the words, forget what lies behind, press on to what lies ahead. Mm-hmm. And I jumped into marriage and family ministry right after that.
What was the opportunity that unfolded when you did that to say, okay, I'm just going to take this and I'm going to see where's the opportunity?
Well, I'd been busy in the offseason speaking to kids and groups and doing some Christian ministry with pro athletes, but there was an invitation from a marriage and family strengthening nonprofit, a small one, to come and help them grow it and build it. And so I jumped into that job right after football, and many years with Stronger Families in the Northwest. And then recently I joined Family Life on a national or international basis to strengthen manhood, marriage, and families.
I was going through a real rough time. I was living in the Philippines, and a really bad thing had happened to me, and I felt really betrayed. And I was going on a mission trip to India, And a wonderful Indian pastor took me aside because he could see I was really hurting.
Yeah.
And he said, what's going on? So I just poured it all out. He looked at me and said, Gordon, Jesus entered his greatest ministry after he was betrayed.
Wow.
And that really hit me. And, you know, and it was true. It became true. Once I said, okay, Lord, you are in charge of everything. You didn't cause this to happen. Somebody took it on themselves to do this.
Exactly.
You didn't cause it. So I'm going to look to you for the solution, and I'm going to look to you to the greater ministry.
That's you're living the message of this book, that the tough things that happen to us, those that we caused or that others caused to us, even the things that are, you know, on a huge international scale are terrible. If we will turn to the source, Jesus Christ, and our Father in heaven, and say, God, how do you want to change me through this blitz? How can you give me the long-term perspective? And how can I bless others through my trial? Then all of a sudden the blitz turns around. And that's what every one of us can do. We can be a blessing to others because we've gone through suffering, and that sensitizes our heart to them, and we comfort them with the comfort with which we received, as it says in Corinthians. So that's just what you went through. And you know, if Jesus was wounded, if Jesus had to suffer, for us to develop the character of Jesus is probably going to take more than some little Bible studies and showing up at church occasionally. We need to go through some trials and to turn to him, to turn to a team, to become more selfless and more other-centered is the key to facing blitzes.
How do you get to the vision where you can see past it? Because I know for me, when I'm in the middle of the struggle, the struggle tends to be all I'm looking at. I don't see past it.
Well, the key to facing blitz is a long-term vision. So to stay in the Word and see Joseph went through blitzes and it turned out for good. Jesus went through blitzes, it turned out for good. Paul and Silas were healing people, preaching, loving people in Philippi, and they got falsely accused and thrown in prison, whipped the flesh off their back, and then chained to the in the inner sanctum of the prison. And they didn't whine, they didn't complain. They remembered, they prayed and they sang. And an earthquake let them out of prison. So, I mean, you need to read the stories that God has given us in the Word, and you need to be around other people. So you and I need friendship. So in my blitz, you're helping me keep the big picture. In your blitz, I'm helping you keep the big picture. That's how we get through the blitz and keep that perspective.
What have you learned that it does to you, that these difficult times, the times where you seem to be pressed down to the point where How do I even get out of bed?
Well, I mean, first of all, they humble you and they remind you, I can't make it on my own. I thought I could. I was kind of doing it my own way. So that's a gift, to be humbled and say, God, I need you. You're more dependent. Secondly, they reshape your identity to be about your relationship with God and how he can use you, not about perfect earthly circumstances, being a starting quarterback, having the job you want, having the popularity you'd like. Those things need to be stripped away, so our true identity comes out as I'm a son or a daughter of God. I'm an ambassador for Jesus Christ. I'm a masterpiece that he made to represent him to this world, and not out of my strength and my perfection and Super Bowl rings. I don't have one of those, but I have a wedding ring. This is a better testimony. So the blitzes bring you A, humility, and B, a new strong identity in Christ, which replaces the shallow identity that we built up as, you know, popular people or successful people.
I don't hear this message much in church today. I wouldn't call it seeker friendly. You know,
the seeker friendly part of it is we have compassion for people in all sorts of trials and tribulation because we've been through it too. And we're not going to hide our imperfections and our blitzes from you. We're going to be real about life is messy and we've had tough stuff happen. Use your blitz, use your tough stories. The tough part of the message is Jesus Christ took the greatest blitz, and he can help you change as a person to be more like him, more other-centered, less selfish, more of an investor in people rather than a consumer. And really, that's where a lot of marriages break down. People are stuck with a consumer mentality. What is she going to do for me? What is he going to do for me? Jesus calls us to love, serve, forgive first, apologize first, and be investors.
Well, I can talk about this a long time, but they're playing the music. The book is available, Facing the Blitz, Three Strategies for Turning Trials into Triumphs. I encourage you to get it.